This is Redstone Aries here, and we're back with another Redstone video. Now, if you haven't seen the title or the thumbnail of this video, you won't know what's going on. You'll be like, what's going on? What am I missing? Right, so we're going to be showcasing a tree farm that I built. Semi-automatic tree farm. All you need to do is plant the saplings. So all you need to do for this farm, so if I plant 10, is what we'll go for. We'll go for 10 saplings. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, No, jeez, no! You can see that then it explodes it all back, which is quite cool in my opinion. Right, and then just keep on doing that for a bit and you get, not loads, but a bit of wood, and it's fairly automatic. Ignore that, I've got to switch on my socket. I'm trying to do it with my foot, it's not working. My headphones are restricting me, guys. There we go. Are you happy now, computer? Yes, you are. Oh, just bang my chair. Terrible. Sacrible. So I should say, basically, what's happening here is when the tree grows, it gets detected, pushed across, around this little piston feed tape and into here. When there's 10 in here, and then push them all across. And then we drop some TNT, and blow it all up. Okay? So, that was so funny. I just look over here and I, yeah, that's another farm. These are resources we will want. I'll just get rid of this oak sapling. So it's all of these bits and bobs. So, yep, I believe that's everything we will need. Yep. So if we come over here. Now this is a bit of a bigger design. So, something's happened to my iPad. Shut up. So if we just build a little platform, we'll do a 3x3, okay? And then this is where you're initially going to grow the tree, okay? It's just so funny to see that just explode every now and again. So what we want to do is we want to make a little thing like this. Now I want to get a lever. We just get this. Place that down there. We actually won't need any more dirt. We can get rid of that, okay? Now what you can do is you can place a block here and here. Just tidies it up a bit. And then what you want to do is you want to get your pistons and place them all the way up like this. And I believe, let me just see how high you need to place them. 1, 2, 3, 4. So you want to place your pistons going up by 6 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now you want to put a little 3x3 cap on top. This just stops the massive trees from growing. We don't want them. Actually, I've put that in the wrong place. Just a little cap like that on top. Let's just do time set day. Thank you. So you see we've got a little cap there. Now what we're going to do, we're going to come around the back here. And now we're going to make the bone meal dispenser thingy. So we're going to place a dispenser there. Now what we're going to do, we're going to place a block. Hang on, let me go and see. Yeah, I don't know fully my design. Okay, that's how we're doing it. Okay, so you're gonna place a block here and blocks here like this. Okay, then you're gonna place torches all the way around there and blocks on top of all of these. Basically, essentially what we're making here is we're making a very fast redstone clock. Now we're going to place a repeat here and a redstone dust there. As you can see, got a really fast clock. that is known as a redstone burnout torch burnout clock. I'm going to place a torch there. That you should see that this turns, like, stops firing loads. And so what we then want to do is we want to not place one there. We're going to place blocks like that, something like that, and then we'll place a piece of redstone there and a repeater here. So you should see when we flick on the lever, you can see a clock turns on, and then when we flick it off, the clock turns off. And we actually want some bone meal. You want a lot of bone meal. I'll just get that. And now what we're going to do, we're going to get a hopper running into here, into the side, and just a chest on top of here. You can take that into a massive bone meal area that's full of bone mealy goodness. We just place that there and we just fill all of this up. Fill up the hopper. Like that. Oh. I thrown it all out. Okay, like that. And then we're going to just fill in this whole chest with bone mealy goodness. Oh. That filled. Just fill it all in. There we go. Now, if you are in survival, you will have to get that bone meal. And that is quite far into the design, actually. What's good about this, you can access the chest. Well, you can't actually access it because there'll be a tree here. So you can't exactly access it, but it's easy. You can just come around the back. Right. Now, what we want to do is we want to make the detection system for when a tree has been grown. It's going to place block here, a repeater there, a redstone torch there, and a block up here. Okay, that should power the repeater. There you go, lost my words. And now what you want to do is you want to bring that out. So if you place two blocks there like that, I believe I have done this a bit differently, but it's not going to make a big deal. And we'll place the redstone torch there, and you want to place some redstone there, and redstone there, redstone there, redstone there, and then redstone here. Now you want to come down a block like that, and you want to place a repeater like that. Now let me just have a look. Oh, there you go. TNT's been dropped. Aha, wrong. You actually want to move this in block by a block. So like that. See, I'm doing a bit of derps. It is a big contraption, so yeah. So now what you want to do is you want to place a block here. Now I'm gonna place a redstone torch there. Block here. Redstone torch there. A block here. Like that, redstone torch, redstone torch, block. Redstone torch and a block. So as you can see, if we place a block here, all the pistons extend and that pushes it out the way, and in this case it would be a tree. And that is you quite far in, actually. You could just make this into a massive block, but we're gonna go one step further. So I would just get a sapling and just check that this works. This only works with oak saplings, by the way. As you can see, tree just gets pushed out away. Okay, so we know that all works nicely. Okay, so now what we're gonna do, if we come over here, we can sort of see what's going on here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So I want to come 12 blocks. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay, like that. And just get rid of all of them. Now I want to come here, place a piston there, like that. So now you want to place a piston there. Now you want to place six up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like that. Actually, you can do it like that. And and shave these off, because it's not actually required. Because trees never grow actually that high. Which is something I've just observantly found out. So now you want to place a block there. Now how have I done this? Over here. There might be a bit of moving around in today's episode. It's just because it's a big contraption. So now what you want to do, you want to place blocks like that, in that sort of format. Place a redstone torch there, and a repeater there. And now, how have I done this again? See guys, it is very hard to remember this because it is a big contraption. Now this might look a bit skeleton-like, but that's just how it will look for now. And you see, you just want to make a little redstone torch tower like that. As you see, they should all be extended. Okay. Now you want to just bring some blocks out like that. Just come around and place Peter running into there. As you can see, so when we place a block there, it just gets pushed out away, and then we're good. So now you want to come. It's probably 12. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 actually. 10 blocks. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So it's here. Now you want to place a piston on the 11th block, it would be. Now you just want to come up 4 pistons again. Like that. Then you want to do pretty much the same system, just like this. So that's blocks like that, yeah. Redstone torch, repeater, block coming up like that, and then redstone torch on the face of that, coming into redstone there, coming into 2 redstone there, and a repeater there. And you want to place block there, block there, block there, and block there. And you just want to place redstone torches on the sides of these blocks like so. Okay, as you can see, that's good. Right, now what's neat about this system is it just brushes it up against that side of the block there. So it's just saying 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, now you want to leave a block here, so no blocks, right? And then you want to place, you will require a lot of pistons for this part. Now you want to place 10 pistons, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Now this will require a lot of pistons. I'm going to place some pistons up here, and then pistons up here. And then you want to do one more though. So that's a lot of pistons right there. That's 40 pistons you have to gather for that. It's a lot of pistons. A lot of pistons. It's not cheap. So now you just want to do that detection circuit again. You should get quite good at these detection circuits by the end of this. Yeah. You should be able to just build them like you don't care really. Now you just want to place blocks running along the back like this. You see, just something simple like this. You see, like that. Then you want to place, does that? Oh no, yeah. And then you want to place another row of blocks. And it does get quite close actually to everything. See, when you start a contraption, just got to place some blocks here. When you start a contraption, it looks quite skeleton, like it did, but now it sort of looks like it's got a bit of meat to it, you know what I mean? Some meat. Now you want to get out your repeaters, get some repeaters, and just come along like that. See? Nice and simple. Now you're going to get your repeaters again and go along top. So this is quite resource intensive. But guys, it's the only way you can do this actually. And now you just want to place redstone just on the back of all of these, like so. So it's nice and simple. Nice and simple. Now we're going to come out. And we're going to connect these two up, like that. And we're going to come up here and connect these up. And I'll just place a block there so we don't get loads of connections going to there. And we can just do something simple like that. So that looks quite simple. Right, so now if we just give our system a bit of a test of what we've done so far. So, place tree. It grows, gets pushed across. Now it will take a little while for you to fill this up. So we will just do a bit of something, a little cheaty. If I just get a wooden axe, we can get rid of our chest now, we won't need them. Gonna go from here to here, slash slash set one. Oh no, slash slash undo. If I do slash, set underscore log. That's not gonna work. Okay. So we'll just have to place these in manually. I know you can actually, this will fill up over time, but I'm not patient enough. And I think you guys will just be happier if we just place these in. Yeah, so I'll be back once I've placed a load of these. Actually, do need to do this off camera. I'll do it on camera. Because there's really not a lot to do for this part. If you were in survival or whatever, you can just sort of AFK a bit, and it will give you some proof that the system actually is working. And there is a lot of logs already in here. When you actually plant a tree, that tree doesn't then go straight into the system. It's another log, but eventually it'll work its way around. Yeah. That'd be very complex to do. So we've got that bit done. So now if we plant a tree, there you go, it's grown. And that's really not that good. Hang on. I've had this exact same problem before. I think it's something to do with the leaves. This is never jammed up actually. Okay, we'll try that again. Place that. It's never actually jammed up like that for me. Why is it jamming up? It's jamming on something. Is that... I have a feeling that this is a one block too far over. Yeah. That we've reached our block push limit. Yeah, so let's just move this all, this bit. So if I go from here to here. No. To here. And I do slash slash cut. I'll walk over one block. Slash slash paste. So now I just need to rebuild this system over here. Luckily it's quite a simple system, so we'll just run it up like that. Run it up like that. It's a bit annoying what's just happened there. But yeah, we fixed it. Should have fixed it anyway. Yeah, that looks good. And that. Ooh. // undo. I gotta undo that because I did. I done goofed. I've gotta move here. Let's do paste. Ew. And paste. There we go. Right, that's in the right place now. Luckily, I hate it when that happens. Now you just want to make sure they're on 0 ticks because, or 1 tick actually, because you don't want a big delay in your system. That would be sucking so badly. Now I've got to actually make sure that saplings will come through the system. That one has to go here, like that. Right, there we go, that should. I don't think this is right, guys. We've lost that torch there. Lost the storm. Okay. I think that's good now. Yeah, we fixed it. Right, so you just need to move that all over by one block. So I did bad stuff. As you can see, it's now pushing along. If we just place 8 more. 1, 2. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right, now you should see when that tree goes, gets pushed along. And there you go, we've got our first little system set up. Now we've got a big part. It may look big, but it's not actually that big, guys. So how long is this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So I want to come out 9 more blocks from here. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, there we go. And we'll put our little another detection unit here. Now this is a slightly different detection unit, so that should be 10 blocks here, and so it should be on the 11th block. So it's a slightly different detection unit, but yeah, it's cool. It's a cool detection unit. Sometimes it's nice to have a bit of a change. So now you can see that it should, when the wood comes, you should get a bit of a clock. Now it's not ideal to be having a clock, but we have a clock, who cares? 1, 2, 3, 4. So now I want to go, actually, so I want to place a repeat here. That stops it being a clock, so that's good. Now I'm gonna go, how many is that? I've got a short memory, guys. 1, 2, 3. So 1, 2, 3. 2, 3. So 3 blocks like that. And then, I think it'll be easiest if we got, you need obsidian for this part. Yes, I know, obsidian. So I believe that's the middle, yeah. If I come out here, there you go. I got a short memory, guys, I don't really know this stuff. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. That's 5. So you want to come 5 blocks away from the detection unit, so. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you want to come down like this, and do something like that. So this will be where, actually no, it wants to be 1 up. This will be where the TNT lands and goes and blows it all up. Hang on, I've got to check. I don't think that's right, is it? Oh no, that's right, that's right, that's right. Now, we want to do something here. We want to place an obsidian block right there. Now, it's just sort of like a bit of a shield, because you don't want it to blow up this redstone torch. I know it has done that in the past with me. It's decided to blow up the torch, which is no good. So now I want to come 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I'd come about 7 blocks up actually. And then we want to place some dispensers. If we get our dispenser out, we'll place a dispenser there and a dispenser there. And now you want to do something like this. Now you just sort of want to do this, and that this helps for the TNT to land actually like here, rather than, you know, sort of a bit off. It lands a bit more dead center. Now I want to place blocks like this. Now you just want to join this up and make sure that it stays quite far away. So if we just do like this, because actually just before recording this, I had the redstone blow up, so I had to change it a bit so it was like this. We don't want the redstone blowing up. It's no good, no fun. So now what we want to do, we want to place a block here, and we want to make sure that it will reach these dispensers, because it probably won't. It won't. So now those dispensers should be activated. Now we get to do something quite fun. Get to get TNT and stuff it all in there. So in one of them and in this one. Now you can put like chests on top that like have loads of TNT in them, but it doesn't run through TNT that quickly. It's not a really big eater of TNT. Now we will adjust that a bit, because that's a bit resource intensive, and so I'll come so we're gonna do it a different way. So I'm gonna come and drop down. This is where the obsidian is, that's right above it. Now we're gonna come 1, 2. Okay, so this is where the middle is. Okay, and now if it's 10 wide, so we're gonna do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, now we're gonna do an extra one on each side, right? Now we're just gonna extend this a decent length so it will catch all of the wood. And go slash set 0. If you don't have world edit or if you're in survival, you can just dig this out. You have to dig it out by hand. Now I'm going to place our water buckets, water down. Just going to place some water down like that. Now we're going to go from here to here, slash set 0. This is what's going to catch our wood. So it's good to have a decently big area, just so you can actually catch the wood. Make this a bit deep. Few blocks deep. Oh dear, I've messed up there. But oh no, I'm placing pistons, so I don't want to place. So like that, and now we're just gonna shave this off. Now we're gonna go another one. Just gonna shave it off until the water doesn't reach anymore. So now what we can do is we can just get a hopper line and then just bring this along here, and then you can run this into a mass storage system. Or what you can do is you can just place a chest, because it's not the most efficient farm, but it's sweet, guys. It is legit so sweet. Now we're gonna get rid of that, and we want a chest. I know I did say that we won't need the chests anymore, but we will. Yeah, you can't quite reach that chest actually from here, so yeah, kind of sucks. You can probably, it doesn't eat through bone meal, like, a lot. But I have had it run dry a bit once. But that is about it. big build, long time to build. So if we just get our saplings and you can start AFKing at this thing. Now we have had some little drama moments where it jammed at the beginning. It was a bit, yeah, but I just did a bit of a goof. I done goof, as they say. Yeah, so just planting our trees. It's really sweet, actually. And what's quite good is you'd think it might take a lot of obsidian to do, but it doesn't really take a lot of obsidian. If we can actually just get some, we can actually get some blocks and build a little shelter thing around this. Like that. And you sort of take us into a path. You make this a bit nicer, but yeah. I think this is a sweet, sweet design. You can even, this is a bit cheeky. No, that's cheeky. That's just cheeky. We're speeding up the process. You can actually do that. That's a sweet idea. I don't know why I haven't thought of that already. Yeah, but we started to make a bit of a block there. So yeah, I will always use this tactic when I want to get loads. Let you just do that. Now, if you do want to AFK at this, I'll just show you what the ideal settings would be. So I often go to controls and I come all the way down here and I do place blocks, I do space. And then because it's always been used, I do this, I do jump and do that. So I just swap them around. And now I put like a weighted item on it and it's just AFKing for me. Now I've just got a camera on there and it's just, you know, it looks pretty sweet. It doesn't look sweet, but you know, I will just walk away. Right? I'm not here, I'm not touching the keyboard. Right, I'm all the way back. Right, I have some Nerf guns on my wall, right? Just take off my headphones a second. I'll go and get one and I'll come right back. Okay, so I'll go and get one. Okay, so I've got a Nerf gun. Got one of my Nerf guns. And this just shows that... No, I'm not touching it. I'm not touching it. I'll shoot it even. Yeah, I hold my Nerf gun with two hands. And I'll shoot it for you guys. Oh, bullets came out. I shot it. That was super loud, so I'm not going to do that again. But it's still going. How much wood have we got from this, guys? Now, it is a bit annoying to move around. As you can see, geez, that's a lot. I'll do a jump cut. And I'll come back when we've got loads of wood in here. Right, so I have just found an issue with it, little issue, but we can just do a little fix. It's a little bomb explosion protection thing. Just gonna do something like that. That should protect it from all these TNTs. Yes, it did actually jam the system, which is never any good. Yeah, so don't, note to self, don't do that. It jams the system. Yeah, and then it does all of this and you have to unjam it. Yes, I hate working with TNT sometimes. And all of this has had a spaz attack. I will just activate this again. It'll just sort of blow up some of the TNT. No, some of the wood. It'll knock it back. And hopefully, if I just do, there we go, that's good. It's just that one. Now I'll just activate it again. See, what happened was it jammed because this repeater. The repeater had been exploded. And then that caused a massive jam. Oh, wait, can't have. Not there. Yeah, the repeater got exploded, so yeah. That caused a jam. Kaboom! I probably will just activate this another time, even though it's not. That's a lot of TNT. It's a lot of TNT. A lot of TNT. Like, I knew I'd done bad. I would actually, if I were you guys, I would actually move this over a bit more. Just so it like is a bit further away from the TNT. So I've realised it's like 5 blocks away from the TNT, which is when I do some tests, is possible to be exploded by TNT. So yeah, I'm just gonna do that, and do that. I will. Once that's done, I'll do that. And now we're sort of like. That's pushed it all back a lot. It's so funny, it's cheaty way I came up with. That's just like so cheaty. But basically, if we do eight more, so that will then fill it all up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8. As you see, go explode. Kaboom! Should explode on the next round, actually. It should. Because it's not actually far enough forward, it's not going to explode. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 9, 10. See, that should now, some of that should be exploded. There we go, so that's brought it back. As you can see, we've got some resources. 23 logs, that's not too bad. Not as efficient as this baby over here. That is quite efficient. Well, this is fully automatic. Yeah, it's fully automatic. It's sweet. I'll probably do another video all on that. So yeah, if you enjoyed, leave a like, maybe even subscribe, and I'll see you all later. Bye!